celebrate God loving us so much that he chose to come to us in the form of a baby boy. The form of a baby boy is so poor that his parents could hardly make ends meet. To a young woman, a mother, 13, 14 years old, to a man who was a carpenter, a stone carver, a masonry, not at all what the world was expecting when the Messiah was to come. The world was expecting a king, a great strength, a great power, a great glory. They weren't expecting a little baby swaddled in clothes. But God came in such a dramatic way that even the shepherds in the field with the flock of sheep knew that something glorious had happened. Now, we think shepherds are kind of cool. But back in the day, shepherds were not cool, folks. Shepherds were kind of gross. They lived out in the fields, they lived with the animals, and if you've been around a sheep, you know that they're not the most intelligent animal that God created. Right? And so these are like the misfits. These are the untouchables. These are the people that really people don't want to go around with. Nobody said, hey, this is my good friend, shepherd. Let's go get some shepherd pie. It didn't happen that way. These were people who didn't really have much connection with the human race because they took their flocks from field to field to field, getting them food and getting them grass, making sure they didn't run away, making sure they weren't attacked by a wild animal. And in the midst of this night, the shepherds get the message from the angels. And then we hear this hymn. And for me, this hymn just takes this whole entire evening and encapsulates it in this beautiful, beautiful story of this little boy who doesn't have anything except a little drum. And we don't even know he plays the drum very well. But he practices. And he decides he's going to give the king something wonderful, but he doesn't have anything. And so in today's standards, you probably would have gone to the king and would have given him at least his drum, because we're a world of materials. He should have at least given the baby the drum. But he doesn't. He goes to the manger, and he plays a meek, simple melody. It's so simple and so beautiful that Mary nods with great pleasure. And the baby Jesus smiles. Our consumer culture would go, what? If you had a baby and somebody walked in and played a couple of taps on their mouth, you'd be like, okay, well, that was nice. No? And so he's like, what is this? What is the story here of being with the little drummer boy? So many of you know I spent 3 months on the Native American reservation in Rosebud, South Dakota. And so I went there while I was a seminarian because I wanted these people to form me as a priest. I wanted this tribe to show me, to teach me what it was like to be a servant. And we're better to learn to be a servant than to serve those that are the most poor in this country. Because the Rosebud Reservation is the poorest land in the U.S. And so I was there for 3 months, and we did a lot of different things. And the one thing that I noticed were the powwows. And the powwow is a dance celebration. And so these little kids would come with this regalia, and they'd be 2 or 3 years old, and they'd get out in the middle of the field, and they would immediately start to dance. The first couple of times, I go, how is this possible? How is this possible that these little kids that are just barely able to walk can dance to the rhythm of these drums? Finally, one of the elder women, she said, well, of course they do. It's natural. And I said, I just don't get it. And she said, the drum in our culture represents our hearts, the beating of the drum. Is the beating of our hearts. And so of course they know how to dance to the beating of their hearts. This is the first sound they heard in the womb. It is their own heart, their mom's heart. Of course they know how to dance. That's what the little drummer boy knew that night. He knew that if he played the simple drum, then it was music that came from his heart to the heart of Jesus, into the heart of Mary. That little drummer boy knew that the beat of the drum connects us all because it's the beat of our hearts that connect us. We may look so different on the outside, and we may believe so many different things on the outside, but it is that rhythm, it is that beat of our hearts that keep us connected. It is that beat of the heart that God gave us to remember where we came from and who we are, and what life is all about. It was the beat of that drum that caused the baby Jesus to smile. It wasn't gas. It wouldn't be in scripture if it was gas. Right? The heart is beautiful. And that is exactly what that little drummer boy gave. There's nothing that we can give that God needs from us. Nothing. But he gives us this thing that beats inside. And he asks us, connect with each other through the beat of the inside, through the beat of the drum that he can